Happy news to you guys. This is Crystal Dragonfly here with a journal. Yay! I'm going to show you how to make a cereal box journal. Yes, that is what all this massive pile is cereal boxes. I know this didn't happen overnight, but it did happen in about 2 months. I have a big family. So, save your boxes. We are reusing to recycle. I mean, instead of throwing them, make something else out of them, guys. So, here we go. The first part of it is, besides saving your cereal boxes, you're going to flatten them all out, besides one. You want to keep one in its upright condition. If you already have some that you keep them like this to keep for scraps or whatever, it's real easy to, you can tape the bottom together, tape or glue it, whichever. And the reason why you want to keep one like this is because it's an easy way to get you the journal cover. Because we're going to take these, and you see our squares out of these, will be our paper for any other journal. We're going to decorate it, we're going to slop some paint down and all that for them to go into the journal. So your size will be whatever your square is there, okay? And then you'll have, that'll be folded, and you'll have, you know, in regrets, 4 pieces, you know, front, back. Okay? So, it's easy to take that same size box, keep it like this, because this will fit your pieces of paper perfectly. Because you're going to take it, and I will show what you're going to do. Very simple to do to get your, I'm having brain fart, guys, your cover ready. Is you're going to cut down each side. You don't want to cut all the way in because they're kind of dull. Okay, and we're going to do the other side. Trying to save those are my better scissors. Because let me tell you, you cut a lot of cardboard with your scissors, they don't last very sharp very long. At least mine don't. I'm just cutting up the corner, on the corner set. Yeah, hollow it out. And I will show you what you're gonna do now. I mean, this is what I found the easiest. So, okay, now we got it like this. What you can do, that one's gonna fall off, which is no biggie. Take that one off since it's gonna fall, is you're going to take this part, you're gonna tape it down here, okay? It gives that extra, gives it one more layer of oomph, so you have an extra strong spine. Okay, then you're gonna take your cover size here, you're gonna fold it in half, like so, and you make sure when you do that, you kind of put it upwards for it doesn't get too, yeah, because when you shut it, if you put it too close, it'll push it out, okay? You're going to do that. You're going to either glue, tape, whatever your lonesome wants, okay? Whatever you want to do to get those together. Glue and tape them if you want. And what you're going to end up with is this, okay? See? Perfect size for it. I had double. So it's extra thick. Obviously, we're not done with it, but this is the base. And the grade is what's great is this is the exact same size, a little bit bigger than your inside here. So your pages are going to fit wonderfully. You don't have to cut them down. Voila, easy peasy. That is how it's done. To get started, guys. So start saving those boxes. Our next step is I'm going to show you again how to do the leathery looking, the leathery type of look for your journal. Alright guys, this is a piece of actual craft brown paper that I have. I wrinkled and wrinkled and wrinkled and wrinkled and wrinkled and got this beautiful wrinkledness going. You could use trash bag. You could use, sometimes you get in the mail, in your packages, they're wrapped in like the brown type, same thing. Alright. So next you're going to want you a PVA glue. I'm actually using mixed media adhesive. It's Hobby Lobby's brand, I believe it is. I got it on clearance. Oh, you know me, guys. I don't pay full price. Don't like it. Don't do it. All right, put some gump down there. I'm not using a brush on this. I'm actually using a piece of too wrinkly piece of cardboard. Got stepped on a lot. So, saves my brushes a little bit when I do it. Use it like this. So you need a good layer of glue, guys. I have showed you guys this technique before on how I showed you how I made my art, arting through tarot journal. So same technique. If you guys have already seen that technique, then skip forward. If you don't have any expensive or white glue, Elmer's works, guys. With school supplies going on sale because of school, now's the time to stock up on that stuff. Trust me. Alright, I already pre-cut the amount. Obviously it's bigger because I'm going to fold and wrinkle and all kinds of goodies. And plus it gives it another layer. Makes it a little bit thicker and more sturdy. So. Yay. Alright, I think that's actually pretty good for that part. Now you're going to take your part. Okay. Right away in the middle, or whatever you're doing with yours. You do not have to do this step. Like I said, this is a step just to get the cool, whooshy, mushy-wooshy technique. So, I'm going to put this down so I don't get glue on my table. Because I kind of went over. Now you're going to screech and screech and screech as much as you want, or as little as you want. Like I said, you don't have to do this. This is just a really cool technique I love. They just look so neat when you're done. Otherwise, you can just paint your cereal box however you want and decorate it for your art journal. So I like that. I really, really, this is really working really wrinkly this time. Flip it over. Hopefully you're still on. Okay. Now your edges here. To get this to lay down, you're going to cut your corners. Okay. It doesn't matter which way you want to go. If you want to go, kind of rub this some more in there. You can go inside first and then outside. It doesn't matter. It's your choice. Your fun, so. Let's see. I need a little more glue, guys. I wish I would have used that before. They had like a bunch of them, but I only bought one because I wanted to try it. So, woe is me. You learn as you go. Now this will take 24 hours to dry, guys. A minimum of 24 hours to dry, depending on your glue and how long. You know, some glues are a lot quicker drying than others, but I would say don't touch it until at minimum 24 hours. Like I said, and that's just because you have a lot of glue on here. And it can take a while to dry. And I still have some spots I just don't want to glue down. Alright guys, so make sure you fold your innards, because if you don't and you lay it out dry like this, when you're done it's almost impossible to shut. So make sure you kind of move it around, get those creases nice and done. Alright, so you can kind of see how that is going to look. It's going to look fantastic. And of course you can actually paint these. You can paint them, they look really cool. You can use, I'm having a spray for inks on them and make it look really old and antique-y, which is what I did on this one. This is my tarotting one. You can see it's got the brownness on it. This one I might actually do paint for you guys can see it. So there you go, guys. Let that dry for 24 hours. And I will catch you back here in a second. Your time, anyways. Alrighty. Alright, guys. Last thing, and while we're waiting for our cover to dry, we can start putting some paint down on these cereal boxes. I would say three signatures of probably three, would make a nice size one. So you're going to want to because here'd be one, two, so it'd be a box and a half for a signature. Okay, now I went ahead and cut off the littler tabs here, just around the bottom. I still have this tab here, and the middle tab, okay? I'm going to go ahead and paint those when I paint my boards, or my paper, because those can be used as, we can make some tags, maybe some pockets, just some little doohickeys for the art journal, okay? So, get cracking, guys. Let's decorate some of these bad boys up. Alright, guys. I got a base paint on every side. Make sure you do both sides, guys. Now comes the fun. We're going to do some stamping, some stenciling, some flicking, some flocking. We're going to put a little bit more because, how boring is that for an art page? To get started. That doesn't give me much inspiration, so we're gonna have some fun making these even cooler. Alright guys, so your cover is dry, alright? So what we need to do is something, of course, with this inside. You can do the same process as the other side if you want it to match. I am going to I used as a backdrop. So some backdrop paper, because I think that would look just so cool for an art journal. So, awesome! I cut it down to the specs I want. I would recommend on these doing glue and tape. That way you are covered. You don't have to, of course, use what you have. Plain and simple, use what you got, guys. But, like I said, I would recommend doing both. That way you are covered. So I'm putting a piece of tape down in the middle of the piece each page. For my... Yeah, that. Hope you guys can see. I'm going to pull you out a little bit more. Trying to keep you in frame, guys. I apologize. Okay, now I'm going to pull those off before I put the glue on. Hot glue works. Techie glue works. Eileen's Techie glue. Mod Pod works. Any and all those would work when doing this. But I'm actually going to sell these, so I try to extra reinforce on the ones I sell. Because that's me. I want them to last for people. So. Alright. Put some glue down here on these spots that aren't. On there. I literally am just slapping it down, guys, and that. No reason to make it perfect. No reason at all. I'm going to make sure to get some in those creeks, the cracks and crevices. You can even use fabric on your journal, guys. You don't have to use paper. You can use fabric to cover your cereal box on your cover. It looks really good. You just gotta make sure you use the right glue for that one. Otherwise, you will be up a creek without a paddle. Alrighty, here. Only thing with that, you gotta make sure you have exactly where you want it before you plop that down. One side, and then if you see, I kind of made I went ahead and did some of the. You see, look, it's not gonna work. You little bitch. Okay, come on, baby. Okay, now I'm actually going to cut the creeks here, cracks and crevices, because I want leeway in my book. Otherwise, you're not going to get any leeway. You're thinking, well, why did you do it this way and not just cut them and then attach? It's just easier to do this part way, guys. It really is. And once you get your pages in there, this won't be noticeable. But if you want to do one more solid, you can take your tape. Decorative tape or masking tape, not masking tape, decorative tape or like a duct tape, and put right in here. That way, it's a little more, but I'm not going to worry about it right now. I'm going to let this dry, because once we put the insides in, you won't be seeing that. I will put probably a piece of tape, but not right now. So, there you guys go. There's your inside. Like I said, it can be anything from homemade papers that you made, or it can be collage type of paper you buy in the store. It can be anything, guys. Anything at all. Alright, guys, now you're going to cut your pieces out, cut your sides out and your middle out, and then you leave with these squares. Now, what I like to do is round the corners, as you can see here. They have gadgets that will do that for you, but if you're like me, you're poor and don't have one. So take you something that's round. I'm using this little plasticky thing. I marked where I want my corners to be. You can see I got a little mark there and there. And I just kind of put it on there and put one edge to edge and then make a mark. They're not gonna be perfect, but they're gonna be mighty friggin' close, and they look nice with the corners, rounded out. It just gives it that, I don't know, look. I guess professional look, I don't know. But I like it. Alright, so see, simple peasy easy. And then you cut those bad boys off. Yes, it takes you a few minutes to do, but let's be honest. If you're watching this and you're gonna make one, you're not really worried about time because you're making your own. So there you go. Doesn't that look nice? And the cool thing is, guys, with all these little scraps that you see, I'm keeping them. These make wicked texture for your art pages. So keep those little corners because they make really nice texture. After you cut your corners and stuff, I ink up the edges. You can use an ink pad. You can use a permanent marker. I'll do both here. They both look good. And once again, that gives it that professionally, I don't know, just brings it all in, truthfully. See? Now that's ink pad. I'm actually running low on my ink pad, so I need to buy me some new ones. Or you can get you, or use a permanent marker. This is a big boy. I was lucky enough to find. And you just put it on the edge and you go down. Heck, you could even take black paint. I've done it, and put it on my finger, and then run my finger on the edge. It works too. So, all right, guys, do your corners up, and then we're going to go to the next part. All right. All right, guys. Now that our pages are rounded and cornered, we are going to fold them in half. There with that. Okay, after you get them all folded in half, you need to make you a template. Okay, I use just this piece of mail I got. And how you're going to do your template is, what I would do is put one hole in the very middle. Okay, this is the same size as my pages here. See? So I'll put one hole in the very middle. And then from the outside in, go in an inch, okay? And then another inch, okay? You could do that up and down. Five holes is plenty, though, for this. It's a very thick, very sturdy, so it shouldn't be no problem. So that's how I did it. And you want to make sure you have a template. That way everything measures up, guys, okay? Alrighty, I'm going to sit here and get these all folded and start punching holes before we can put our book together. Alright, guys, I just got done putting my, because we're doing three signatures, so I did three sets of holes. Once again, I start in the middle and then kind of go out from there. Obviously, I didn't start through the back, but I am going through, because some of my holes, you know, it's kind of hard to get through some of this cardboard, your cereal box, especially when we, like, double up like we did. So, I actually went through that way first, and then I took my pokey and went into the back. This is a key, guys. I'm going to tell you, now that I've been making journals and different types, the key is to make sure your holes are good. Because if they're not big enough, God, that sounds bad. If your holes aren't big enough, it's going to be harder on you to thread your journals or books or whatever you're making like this. And of course, we use tape also besides, and the thing about using tape with journal spines is it'll get on your awl or your pokey, whichever you're using. So make sure you clean it up in between, otherwise it's going to get so gunked up, you're never going to get it clean, and you don't want that. Alright, so I got my cover done. And I did also want to make sure you notice on your template, put a T for your top, okay? I don't know how many times before I started marking them, I screwed up because I didn't mark it, and then I go do one signature one way, and then I end up flipping it, and guess what? I do it the other way and have shit upside down, and of course have something on your desk to protect it. Alright, so this is three signatures here. And I'm going to show you how I do these real quick. I'm just going to put them right here. I usually use a clippy. One or two clippies, depending on how many pages I have. Really, on these cardboards, really don't have to worry about that. Put it right in the middle where you use, see? If you want, you could clip that on there if it's easier for you. My old one, actually, I had my cardboard bent, so it was easier to put in. But not anymore. Alright, so I just poke your holes in, guys. Follow your template. I know I'm in your way. Sorry about that. That way your holes will coincide with your journal book. So. And of course, I don't push hard for the first ones. Let's see with cardboard it goes through. There you go. That's one set, guys. Do that to the other two signatures. Alright guys, now for the fun part of sewing your journal together. It's really not bad. A little tidbit though, if you have these clips, clip it onto the end of your thread you're using. That way it doesn't have a chance of coming through your book. So, you can use, this is actually Coates & Clark's nylon thread. I spent $2.55 on it at Hobby Lobby. It's very thick, but you can use embroidery thread. You can use anything you friggin' want, guys. And that's the truth. So, I am going to actually start, I think, at the top. Come in and out, because I want my thread to be at the top before I can do some dingly. So, ease that one in. Super easy, guys. Super, super easy. And look. It won't come through. Just a little tip from me to you. It's kind of harder for me because I'm standing and doing this where you can see what I'm doing. There's a second hole. That way y'all can see what's going on. Pull that string. Okay, then we go in through the third. I guess it's harder to do with me trying to show you guys than if I don't have to. In and out, guys. If you don't want to start at the top, you can start in the middle, on the inside. It's totally up to you where you want it. Okay? So, up to you. Okay, once you go through once, guys. Alright guys, we went through once. Now what you're going to do is go back through your holes for you end up on top, okay? Back through till you're on the top, okay? Alright guys, we went down and we went come back up, and this is where we're at. You have your two strings and you're going to tie those off right here. Tie them tight. As many times you want, at least, I would at least do three times because, you know, three is a magic number. And pull tight. Alright, so, now let's do the other two signatures. You guys, I think, got this, and we'll be back. See how that looks? Alright guys, we have all the signatures sewn in. I left my stringies for now. Looks pretty good. Pretty good, pretty good, pretty good. I like it. So now as you can tell, I've been kind of working on the cover. I was going to paint it, but I think on this one, I'm still going to go with the leathery, worn type of look. So far what I've used is I've watered down some brown acrylic paint, rubbed on. I've used my brown alcohol spray, sprayed it in a cup, and then used it like that. Now I'm going to take my oil pastel, and I just broke off, rub some on my finger and kind of get into those edges that, just to give it a little more, another depth, That's all it is, guys. You want it to look wrinkled. Well, it's already wrinkly, but you want to bring those out. You want to make it look worn and weathered. Alright, so after we're done decorating your cover, really it's easier to do it before you put your book, your journal together, but I was debating what I wanted to do, so otherwise I would recommend doing it before you sew in your signatures, but I was doing it, as always with me, I do the difficult, so. Alright, so after this, I'm going to cover the cover in sealant. I use Mod Podge for mine. You can use whatever you want, or you don't have to steal it if you don't want. I do because it keeps it from going, if something gets spilt on it, it can be wiped up. So that's why I do, and it gives it that shimmery shine, and it gives you one more area of hardness, so. Alright, I like the look of this, so I'm going to do Mod Podge, and then we will come back and work on all those extra pieces that we, all these chunkies we got left, figure out what to do with them. Alright guys, now that your journal cover is dry, if you recall, we did three signatures of three. Well, we had an extra square, so I cut it in half. And I cut it like diagonal on a piece. And we are going to use this to put in here as a pocket. And then we're going to use this one on the back. I would recommend for this part using super glue. I'm using hot glue because that way I know it's going to stick. A chance of it coming off by putting stuff in is a lot thinner of a chance, so. She kinda gotta work kinda fast, but. Get that bottom back done. And yes, I got glue stuck out, so what I'm gonna do is use one of my sticks here to wipe it up, because I don't want it to be all hibbity jibbity. And you can just peel it when you're done with it. Okay, there's that part. Hope you guys are seeing it. So now I'm going to put some down here, and then we'll have this nice pocket. I'm not gonna bubble it up a little bit because I don't, you know, I want it to work. So I'm gonna actually, I don't want it to do it so flat where they're not gonna be able to put something in, guys. I would recommend trying to kind of do it looser. One of your edges a little bit looser than the other. Kind of see how I did that? Kind of hold it up a little bit. Alright. So there is one pocket. I will clean that up after it's dry, but there's one. Okay, we're going to do the same thing for back here with this one. You don't want to watch me do another one, I know, so let's keep moving on, okay? Now, the since I didn't actually put a, as you see, I didn't put a clasp. Usually I'll put something in between the front and back and run it out, but I didn't want to this time, so what I'm going to do is actually use a piece of lace that I like, and what I'm going to do is put it in the middle. I'm going to glue the front and back. I'm going to leave this part unglued because if you glue it, if you don't, when you open and shut, it's going to pull at that and you're going to have all kinds of issues. So glue the front and the back, and then you're going to have a wonderful tie, okay? Now, I only have this white, and it's really, it's bright on there. So I'm actually going to use a little paint and dirty this up with. You can use anything you have that will work. Your inks will work, which is what I'm probably going to end up doing. So, I I don't want it black, but I don't want it white either, so we're just going to kind of rub it up and down and get it looking a little bit dirtier, you know? Alright, so that's how you do that part. So that's what I'm going to do right now. Alright guys, I got the pockets in. There's the front, there's the back. Woohoo! Okay, now on the other half of that page, I cut up some little mounting boards. I did one in here. I just, like I said, took the half of the half that we used for the pockets, used that mounting board, cut some strips of other pieces that are left over, made this pretty little thing, and guess what? It is also a pocket. Okay. So, besides making mounting boards and creative things like that, I also use this pieces. You can cut pieces out, especially if you get some funky scissors, if not, just square. And you can make some, I'm going to glue these on for like some tags. That way, each section has, I'm going to put it for each section. And you want it different. I don't want to use the same one on there, so I'm going to probably do that one here. And we're just going to hot glue it. Simple little things, guys, that make your journals yours. Like, so make sure you stick out just a little bit, that way that tab sticks out, okay? Alright, I'm going to do that to the rest, and I think we're going to do maybe a couple of tags for it, and then we'll work on the back. Alright, guys, so I've been using the scraps to make a couple tags here. Nothing huge, just some kind of plain ones, that way whoever buys journal can add more to it. Okay, and I'm going to show you how to do one of these. You can make them as simple or as beautiful as you want. You can make big ones, little ones, it's up to you. Okay, first off, you're going to, for me, I round my edges. We already talked about how to do that. And then you need a hole punch to punch a hole. Okay. You can use lace. You can use craft. String. Hemp rope. Anything and everything for your dangly pretties up top. You don't even actually really have to do that, so if you didn't want to, you don't have to. Alright, get that through there, okay, or you get a little hole, and then you take the rest of those up through the hood, and then you pull them. Individually, there you go. Okay, so what can you do with your, you can do anything you want. You can go around with your ink pad or your permanent marker. Always makes them look kind of good, but I'm trying to use up the scraps. So as you can see, I did a flowery one, I did some circles, I cut circles out by hand. This I do have a punch. A lot of the punches, though, don't work on cardboard, so they're not going to work on your cereal box. I'm just being honest. They're very picky about that. So, I was thinking on this one, you know, we kept all these scraps up here. I'm thinking maybe put a few on here different ways. Just go with different colors, different ways. I think maybe trim them up a little bit. Just something different. Let's see. We've got these here. You can do whatever your heart desires. See, I got that piece here. I'm gonna go ahead and cut this. Look at that. Some weirdness here. Doesn't necessarily have to make sense, guys. anything you want. A lot of these little pieces. Put some little jewels on. You normally wouldn't use the hot glue gun on this part, but I already have it already heated and ready, so might as well use it. So, that is what we're doing here. Wanted to keep with the abusing scraps, you could cut that little circle and put on there, whatnot. I'm actually going to use some of my beads, I think, with a little bit of a cool thing for something different. So. Something like that, guys. So, there you go. There's that tag. I'm not doing anything else on it. Because, like I said, this is going in there. So, I hope you guys like the little tags we made. Like I said, you can go really, really extravagant with the tags. So, alright, guys. We are done with it. I didn't show you guys me stringing beads because really, how boring is that? So, you can use any type of beads. Even I've got actually buttons, those old flat buttons with little gems on. So I just do that. Not at one trick I would recommend is at your end bead, put a dab of, up in there if you guys can see, of hot glue just as an extra reinforcement. Okay, so there's that. I like it. And here it is. Okay, so you see how it's not so white because I did dirty up my ribbons. Okay. And this is a art journal. So we got this. It's a pocket here. We've got tabs. You can see the tabs on here. And then we've got, of course, I showed you this. And it's a pocket. I put the tags in the pocket there. More tabbies. I mean, I could put more pockets and more boards, but I want to leave mainly the space for them to make. And I can't put think happy, be happy. To put what they want on their journal. Because when you buy it, you know, you want to be able to do your own thing to it. So that is that. I hope you guys enjoyed this. How to make a art journal out of cereal boxes. There you go. If you want to hit me in the down bar, tell me, how much would you pay for this beautiful book? I'm just curious. And also, the next one I'm going to make is, we're going to do some cereal boxes, loose page cereal boxes with rings. Because I love this, it looks gorgeous, but it is smaller pages, so if we want to use the bigger page, we're going to try a different way next time, so. Until next time, happiness to you. Go make a mess and save those cereal boxes. Blessings. Bye.